if you're someone who is struggling to manifest something, or maybe there's something in your life that you are really desiring and wanting, and you're really having a hard time having that come to you through the law of attraction, this video is for you. I'm going to go over and share with you 4 steps or things that you would need to do in order to manifest lightning freaking fast, along with removing anything that is blocking you from achieving the kind of happiness and whatever desires it is that you want. So if you're struggling with that push and pull to manifest something, maybe you're getting frustrated with the whole concept of you have to want it, but you got to let it go. Or maybe you're at a point in your life where you're like, what the bleep is going on? Why is this not coming to me? This video is really going to help you out. So if that sounds really good to you, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up button right now. We'll consider that a virtual high five between the two of us. So if you're brand spanking new here and you have no idea who I am, give me a second, let me introduce myself. My name is Judi Jamieson and I am a psychic. What I do is teach intuition and psychic development to empaths who are going through some kind of life transition, spiritual awakening, or trying to heal from toxic and abusive people. Because we all know, as empaths, we naturally attract those type of people to us. It just comes with the territory. So if you're someone who is an empath and tired of life's BS, and you want to learn how to really power up and step into your powers to really come to life with the help of your spirit guides, I am your new virtual best friend, and you're going to want to hit the subscribe button that is right underneath this video. If you're not already a subscriber, I'm going to give you a second to do that right now. Make sure you hang out to the end of the video because I have 2 freebies for you that will really enhance and skyrocket your natural intuitive and psychic development. All right, you ready? Let's get this party started. So let me tell you, before I give you these 4 steps, the one critical component or concept or thought process that you need to understand when working with the law of attraction, because it can get extremely freaking frustrating. You don't manifest or attract to you what it is that you're desiring in here. What you attract to you is what's going on here deep within your subconscious that you may or may not be aware of. So to give you a quick example, say you're wanting to attract to you more financial abundance, right? But when you're looking at that on the outside perspective, the worldly shell, it'll look like that's what you're really wanting and desiring and what you're thinking or believing, right? But when you go deep within and do shadow work into your subconscious, why that may not be coming to you, maybe you have a fear of having money. Maybe you think if you gain all this money that people are only going to love you for your money or what you can provide to them. Maybe you're terrified of success because it's new territory for you. You kind of get what I'm saying here? The same thing applies with love. If you're someone who is single and you're wanting to attract love to you, when you go deep within and look within what it is that you're truly attracting, maybe you're terrified of love. Maybe you don't feel on a deep subconscious level that you may not even be aware of that you're not deserving or worthy of love. So the key concept here, you manifest and attract to you what is going on deep within your subconscious, whether you're aware of it or not. Coming from someone who manifested the shop that I used to work out of, 2 houses, a sports car, a brand new freaking SUV, and a boatload of other stuff super freaking fast, I got some experience on how this stuff really does work. So the first thing that you want to do is what's called shadow work. This, when you do shadow work, this is the reason why I say when you're trying to develop your natural intuitive and psychic gifts or working with your spirit guides, it is so critical, the relationship that you have with yourself. You have to know yourself on a very deep and intimate personal level. You have to be able to integrate your light and your dark, the yin and the yang that is within you. You learn what this stuff is and what is blocking or preventing you through what's called shadow work. This is where you go deep within and heal subconscious wounds that you're not even aware of because you're going about living your regular physical worldly life. Shadow work is the ability to go deep within your subconscious, deep into the depths of your soul, which is generally a very scary thing for people. But when you go deep into that darkness, that darker side of yourself, the ego, that is where you get these secret keys to certain treasure boxes, where you learn why that box is closed and why the lock is on it. The second thing that you want to do is become one with the energy of what it is that you are desiring. You have to feel it with every freaking bone in your body. You have to live, eat, and breathe it like you already emotionally have it. Daydream like freaking crazy and become one with that dream, knowing that there is nothing stopping or preventing it. You have to truly believe it with every ounce of your soul and not second guess whether or not it's possible. Think of it this way. Your brain and your emotions doesn't know the difference between if you went on that vacation last year to Disney or if it was something, a fantasy in your head, right? So when you're constantly tuned into the energy that you already have it, and I'm going to share with you some examples here as to some basic things that you can do. When you tune into that energy, it became one with what's ingrained into your subconscious, and that is the vibe and the light that you're giving off. The third thing that you want to do is combine that energy or thought process into your physical world. You can do creative woo-woo type things or energetic type things, create certain rituals or routines, whatever terminology works for you, because it's all the freaking same. It all boils down to the same end result. So to give you an example, the sports car that I manifested, while I was driving my old piece of shit mommy mobile minivan, I was visualizing as I was in that vehicle that I was driving this super hot freaking sports car, and I was tuning into the energy of it and tuning into the vibe of it and listening to the music that raised my vibration. I threw it out there into the universe that I wanted a Firebird or a Trans Am with T-tops, and it had to be black, right? I also threw it out there, I was only going to pay $1,000 for this car. You have to tune into the energy that is, it is real and it is realistic. I shit you not, I got that freaking car for $1,000 and there wasn't nothing wrong with it. The house that I manifested, right? You may not be in an area that you like, but if you tune into that childlike state and allow yourself to just vibe with it and live it like it's real, you ignite and connect and remove any of the blocks that are there. So one of the things that I like to do was go to IKEA and walk around the floor models and visualize, this is my huge master closet, or this is my beautiful bathroom, or this is whatever the freak it is. And I would actually sit my ass in the chairs in the IKEA setups and visualize this is my home and take it in like it is a freaking fact. When you're doing that, you're removing the blocks, you're connecting with the energy of it, you're connecting your physical thoughts and your emotions, or you're connecting your thoughts and your emotions on an energetic level to something physical. The other thing that you can do is journal things out, right? I made a whole detailed list of what my home looked like, what it felt like, how it was decorated. That house came to me. The fourth thing that you want to do is pay attention to the people, places, and things that come into your life once you've set this manifestation process. You kind of have to go with the flow, knowing that it is on its way to you, and everything that is happening in your life is happening for you, not to you. The universe is quote unquote preparing you for what it is that you asked for. You just got to release the control and the desperation and freaking relax and allow it to come to you. So to give you another example, for a little while there I was working on manifesting love, and I was sitting on my couch watching something on Netflix, and there was this foreigner guy who was dark skinned, who had like a really sexy freaking accent, who was not from the United States. And I thought to myself, you know what? I'm like, dear universe, dear guides, I'd like to meet someone who is not from this country who has a phenomenal freaking accent. I shit you not, like 2 weeks later, a man from Brazil approached me, right? So then I realized, oh shit, there really is something to this when you really set the intention. I was like watching this Netflix show, like this man with this accent was my guy. And then you just kind of build on top of that. Once you get the momentum going, there's no stopping how fast it comes to you. So let's do a quick recap here before I tell you about these freebies I got for you. Understand the law of attraction, manifesting, and removing blocks to abundance all goes down into your subconscious. What is your belief system? Do you really believe this is possible? If you don't, or you're struggling with it, it's kind of the same concept like you want to win the lottery, right? But maybe deep down inside you're like, yeah, what are the freaking chances? Guess what? You just blocked it. You manifest what is going on a subconscious level. So you have to be very self-aware. All right, so step number one, shadow work. Step number two, you have to energetically connect with it and feel it like it's already truth. So if you're trying to manifest, say, your dream dream job. In the morning when you get up and you're getting yourself put together, get yourself put together like you're going to that freaking job. When you get in your car and you're driving there, visualize that you're driving to that job. When you get to your place of employment, even though in the physical it's not the place that you want to be, visualize that you're sitting in your office or you're sitting in your chair, and the work that you're doing, you get the process here. Energetically become one with it, like it's real. 3, combine physical things into that energetic spiritual place. And I already gave you a bunch of examples on how to do that. 4, pay attention to the people, places, things, opportunities that come to you, and know as each thing is coming to you, it's preparing you for what it is that you asked for. Sometimes we ask for things that we're not quite ready for, right? We got to do some energetic work. Then what happens? Your spirit guides throw in all kinds of monkey rails and things to get you either to be in pain, to heal, or people or opportunities that will lead you to drawing to you what it is that you want. So I got 2 questions for you, right? Because the whole reason why I like to do these videos is to make them interactive. The only way that's gonna happen is if you comment below. So question number 1, if there's something that you manifested that you didn't think was possible, please share it with me below. Tell me what it is that you were desiring and how it came into your life. 2nd thing, if you're struggling with this kind of stuff, comment below and let me know what you're struggling with. This way I can make a video to help you out if it's something I have experience with. All right, so I told you I had 2 freebies for you. The first one is 30 different ways to develop your natural, intuitive, and psychic gifts. I can give you 1,000, right? 30, I think, is a really good run and start, and you just pick and choose what floats your boat or what you feel an energetic vibe or connection to, and then just go with the flow on that one. The second freebie I have for you is cord cutting. When you're doing shadow work and cord cutting, you have to constantly make sure that you are a clear conduit and channel, not only to receive your intuitive messages, but pick up your outside psychic messages. Cord cutting is something that I do on a daily freaking basis. It is important for your personal growth and success when it comes to working with the law of attraction and your spirit guides. Now, I also have a 3rd thing for you. It's not a freebie though. If you want to fast pass and skip to the front of the freaking line and really, like, within the next 5 minutes, learn how to develop your natural intuitive gifts and your outside psychic gifts, along with learning how to read energy, how to feel things and read energy, how to read cards, how to do all kinds of fun, like woo-woo type stuff. Underneath this video is the 2 freebies, along with a link to an online course I have called Open Your Intuition and Your Psychic Senses. That course, I'm gonna give you 45 years of personal experience, because I do live, eat, and breathe this stuff, in one whole big ass, beautiful, high quality video course. So there you go, that's what I have for you. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, you found it easy enough, please give it a thumbs up, comment below, talk to me. I do get notifications and I do reply back. I hope you have a wonderful, phenomenal, kick freaking ass day. Go do the shadow work, do the cord cutting, tune into the energy of it, and incorporate the physical into your desires. I guarantee you this stuff works. So like I said, go have a wonderful, phenomenal, high vibrational, kick freaking ass day. See you later. I got something in my freaking teeth.